Hey, what's more important, lipstick or designer series paper? This is Ann Klemmer and Stamper from stamperdog.com. We're going to make some quick little pop-ups or gift card holders, depending on how you make it. So stay tuned and let's get started.
Stamper, come.
Not that I'd want you to confuse me with someone else that puts their lipstick on, but, you know, some things just have to happen. And you don't want to look at this here. Ah. Maybe one of these will go home with you today, because I want to know, what are you thankful for? I am so glad I am here today. Do I even have it on straight? You know... when I look at this, I don't like my forehead showing. Oh, see, now Louise said paper's more important, but see, I don't even have anything I can look at here, because I don't want to be talking to you and go, oh, look at me. Let me try that again. Hold on. I look at it sideways and I really don't even see myself. You know, I can fix this. Thank you for your patience. You know, those of you who have been around me, you know, for a while, you know that every now and then it just gets crazy. It gets really crazy. And, you know, since they went and made this, extended this special, yes, it's crazy. That's the other thing. When I'm looking at the screen at me, I'm backwards. So anyway, yeah, you want to get in on that special. And if you have a coupon with me, hey, make sure that you read the coupon. So yeah, Chrissy, I saw that this morning. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Yesterday morning I was up, it wasn't just that they didn't have the right prices on the sale things. It's that the whole entire sale inventory disappeared for about 5 hours. And I am so glad that, you know what I'm thankful for? I'm thankful that I don't work in IT. And I'm glad he doesn't either. Hey, and by the way, I did wear my official greeter shoes. There you go. Yes. Here, I'll give you a little scratch there, Stamper. Trying to put lip gloss on and scratch the dog and talk to you all at the same time. And, you know, hey, I'm blessed. I'm thankful for everything. You know, when people say, what are you thankful for? Hey, honey, everything. Because that's just the best way to look at things. Today, I wanted to do this gift card holder, but then I went, oh, should I be doing last minute things, you know, for people to do? You know, to get together for, you know, well, this thing that I'm going to do, you could use it for tomorrow if you really wanted to. You wouldn't have to put a gift card in it. But I want you to remember those people who are delivering stuff, okay? Like Black Friday, someone shows up on your door. Hey, give them a gift card. You know, you can buy these things like in bulk and just be, you know, and like I do. And then you just have them by the door, just hand it to them, you know, just not when they're expecting it, you know, just hand it to them. So yeah, make sure you get in on this special, you know, and it ends tonight at midnight for sure. I mean, Stampin' Up! Did the right thing by going and giving you an extra 24 hours because they missed five. And, you know, it was a worldwide thing. So it was just really crazy. And one thing that I really important that I want you to remember, hey, it's important to do self-care. You know, like you wouldn't let your phone run out unless you're my friend Barbara. Well, not Barbara, Barb, two different people. You know, so, you know, just don't like overdo. And, you know, I don't like this picture, this piece that I picked. Uh-huh. I don't, you know, in fact, I don't like any of them. You know, but let's say we're going to give it to a guy, so we're going to do wood. Yeah, yes. Yes, people have been able to get onto the site. You know, if you're having problems, Connie, just give me a call or just email me what you want. I have to tell you, I was sending something to Kay, and I didn't change the address from mine to hers, so I might have to ship it twice. Yeah, isn't that fun? So, yeah. Yes, we can get onto the site. And you know, that's another thing. You know, for my clients, if you have computer problems, I can, you know, like share a screen and help you. I don't do anything on your screen. I just sit there and watch and tell you what to do. And that way, and I do that with my team too, so that they, you know, because that's kinetic learning, just like stamping. That's why I always like stamping parties, because you got to do something. You didn't have to just sit there and go, oh, that pen's pretty. Yeah, I think I'll write down and get that. You know what I mean? You got to go and make something. And that's what's so cool. That's always been what I loved about stamping parties. And I'm not really one to go to makeup parties. This is about as naked as Anne gets in public. Yeah. Well, I do have pants on. Okay. I always have pants on here. If you're wondering, I always wear pants, because when I walk over here, I don't know how much you're going to see. Oh, you can't. Okay. Okay. So yeah, Connie, let's talk about this right after I get off. So, okay. So what we're going to talk, We're going to start off with that self-care thing. And here it is. Here it is. This is, yeah. As you grow older, you'll find that the only things you regret are the things you didn't do. So like, if that's speaking to you that you want to join my team, then you should do it. And you should do it now. Because while it might not be a real fancy offer, anything that you get from the main catalog that is not on the exclusion list will be 10% off on top of getting it. In other words, they recognize the sale price in the starter kits. And we had a new person join down in Puerto Rico. Luz, yes. So see, look at, I mean, so somebody's going, yeah, they're thinking cap on. And then they're going to be ready for when our biggest sale of the year starts in January, which is Celebration. It's, yeah, I'm not going to say any more about that. I do know some things. I do know some things, but I don't want this to apply. Do not look where you fell, but where you slipped. That's a good one. That is a good one. It's hard to know which one of those I like the best. So let's get started with this, holder. But I do have to tell you, things move around here. When I was showing these, I never attached it, but a couple people mentioned it. And yes, you do need to go and attach the designer series paper behind that if you're putting that in the mail. But I still think, because even with my finger running over this, the only way you're going to get really good adherence is if you go and put that sheet adhesive over this whole thing so that it will attach to this. And that's why I would not go and put this through the mail. That's just me. You can do what you want. Oh, yes. You know, now that you mention this, hold on. You know, it's one of those things where my little area here has gotten a little bit smaller than I thought it would. Because what I did, I want to show you this about the magnets. You know, I talk about how this is something, and I don't want to show you the front because, let me see if I can go out farther. There you go. This is something that I get, and just contact me and I'll give you a link directly to it if it speaks to you. What I do is, because I like things to start on Sunday, yeah, I always put Sunday's date up here. This is just me. And then I just write the number date up here. And then my husband and I, we write on here what's coming up for the week. So he knows, like, this says live at one, live at one, live at one. Barbara, Thanksgiving, you know, I'm telling you what's on this without showing it. Yeah. So anyway, so this, but it doesn't come with, you get two of them and they're not very expensive. I can't tell you how much they are. There are different styles. But I have to tell you that this one works because you've got a lot. We write with Sharpie markers. You don't have to go up and look at it really close. It's just something we do every Monday morning. But I'll show you what we did on the back. Now, these are the 4x6 magnets. These are not the 5. You could use 5x7. And I weighed this, right? I weighed this. Now, the link right here, yes, we're saving up for a dog bed. So, yes, that'll go towards that. And we appreciate it when you use the link. You just don't go there and then save it for later. So anyway, these are the 4x6 ones, but it's because I'm trying to use them up because the 5x7s are the ones that fit best, right? But I put two of these. This is over half a pound, and it does not move on my refrigerator. So see, you could go and do that. Yeah, you can go and do that. And then if you want to have a whole bunch of them there, that is the link. But you have to put the W is in front. I don't know why. It just that one. That's the way it is. But these are great. And like I said, I prefer that they start on Sunday. But I like it. I bought one that was like that. And you know what? The boxes weren't big enough. And so, you know, we're experienced and we like things that we can just glance at from afar rather than walk up and have to get your bifocals out. I am out a goat for a Christmas card. Okay. Yeah, I needed to know that, Kay. I don't know. I must have missed the beginning of that conversation because Beverly's talking something about macrobiology. Oh, yeah. So, okay. So here we go. Just pick some designer series paper. Go and pick. And I should have told you this right up front so you could make this along with me. Because see, I have a little prototype that I made with some retired paper. And this is something that will keep you for a long time. But you're going to want to cut it 11x4. So just run over there and grab it. Because I have to cut this one down too. This is a half sheet. Now I had a trimmer around here somewhere. Trimmer. Come out, wherever you are. Come out. Oh, it's right underneath the keyboard. On the floor where all good keyboards should be, right? Now, if you're wondering why this says score up here, that's because that just reminds me that the scoring blade is up there. And hold on, let me double check this. And I'm sure it is. Boy, what a waste. This would have been better if I would have cut it out of a full sheet. But you're important to me, so I'm just going to go with it. Okay, hold on. 4 inches. Boop. I'll use that 2 inches on some. Hey, maybe we'll use it on the wrap. I don't know. And then I'm just going to cut. Now, for me, the easiest way to cut an inch off is right there. And I just about always go in. Today, you'll see where I might not go straight into the flat edge. I do keep smaller pieces of designer series paper while they're current. Anyway, I wanted to use something that would be on sale. So, you know, that's why I did this. So, okay. So we're going to take this and we're going to score it at, and this may not be the right side, you know, let's see. On the wrong side. I'm going to score it at 2.25. So write this down. I don't have any graphics coming up. The producer's busy, see? Yeah. So that's 2.25. And from this other end, 3.5. Now, I saw this, but we're going to be doing this a little bit different than what somebody had said. Yeah. Actually, you should do it. If you want to be technically correct, you want to do it at, and do it on the right side up. Okay. So just, you know, come on, we're just playing with this time. Now I'm going to go and 1/2 inch on either side. Half inch. Monkey see, monkey do. Oh my goodness. Okay. That reminds me, I've got happy mail. Hold on. Let me call my favorite guy. So if you're wondering why my mic didn't work, you know, I have a magic button here and I could do that, but I'm not going to. I think silent is much more fun. Okay, so 1/2 inch from either side, 1/2 inch from either side. Now I have to look at my prototype real quick. Yeah. Here you go. Look at this. Hold on. Yeah, look what I got from Nancy. I didn't get these. And by now, you know, it's like if they make the new catalog, I'm definitely going to get them. I wish this would go in the new catalog too. Beautiful. Isn't that beautiful? Isn't that nice? Okay, so now here's the way I'm doing it. These are the new scissors, right? And I'm going to cut straight in on the fold, right? Now don't be working ahead because, okay, and then I'm going to do my little, is that an isosceles triangle? Is that a right triangle? No, that's a right triangle, right? And then I'm going to go over here and see if you can't see that, which it's kind of hard here. I'm just going to go and take my scissors and kind of rub along that. But I really have a hard time with that one. Right. Oh boy. See, and now, see if I get it in just the right light. Come on in. And then I'm going to cut in like this. And don't work ahead because you'll see what I... Now you're going to do the same thing on the other side. Hello. Right triangle. But if I start telling people, yeah, and cut an isosceles triangle here, they're going to laugh me out of town. Okay, now you're going to get your trimmer back out. Okay, so see, you got that? You could go ahead and draw this if you need to, but I definitely, if you're not getting this during the live stream, go and watch it on the replay. And now I'm going to bring out my trimmer again. And what I'm going to do is kind of look, see, it's easier to find on the other one. I think if I used anything other than this, it would work. Now what you know, it'd be easier, but this has a lot of lines in it. So you want to get that scored edge right there in that ditch, and you want it to match up at the bottom. Now there's two ways that you can do this. See, there goes that scoring blade. See, there's a line right here, and let's see how close I can get this without it going. See this line right here? Line that up with that scored area. And I can't, you know, it's funny because when you look in the camera, it looks like it's not even, but it's right. Okay. There you go. And And then I'm going to do the same thing down below. Hold on. Now, here I went and put both of those up there. I'm doing it down below, and then I'm just bringing it up. Now, I'm going to do the other way, just so that you can see that it works. But here, I can only go out. I can only go out so far. That's the way it's going to be. Now, we're going to flip it around. Now, if you're more, it's whatever you're more comfortable with, but you want to get that. See, you can't even see that line, right? But you want that line to be in the, in the ditch. Now, the other way you can do this, and you want to make sure that you're holding this down. Oh, yay, Connie. Pull this down and just get really slow when you get by the, close to the score line, because you're going to feel that paper release. And I just went down and I knew it was coming. And I kind of slowed it down and I could feel where it hit that right there. And see, look, it gone. So there's a couple different ways you can do it. You can go in or you can go out. It's whatever you feel most comfortable with. I kind of like to go in. You can do this with cardstock as well. If you do it with cardstock, you can do it with a regular 8.5 by 11 sheet. You can get two of them out of an 8.5 by 11 sheet, 3 out of 12 by 12. So now, see, I cut that a little bit wide, but oh, golly, my life is over as we know it. There we go. So, okay, bone folder. Oh, you know what? I didn't do the right amount. Ah. Okay, no. Don't do as I say, not as I do. I told you I only made this once. This is where you want to clip it in, right here, where that is. Yeah, we won't be releasing it. Yeah. See, you could take a pen. It doesn't matter because you're going to be cutting that off. There you go. So that's where you do it. I was like, golly, I knew, you know. I have beginner's luck. You know that. If you've been around here, you know that I have beginner's luck. The first time I make things, it's the best. So here, I'm going to cut it in here. Cut this. There you go. I'm still going to use my... And if it's easier, look at... This is the other way you could do it. Just cut that up to where the, boy, this is that my other stuff was so much easier to see. Boy, this lined wood stuff. What was I thinking? I was thinking I wanted the show to start. That's what. And look at, I can do this on here too. It's just go in and line that up. Make sure that's lined up with the ditch and you can't, yeah, you can't see it. Okay. Oh, wow. See, now this does not work. I'm going to have to fold that back because it impedes, there's your college word, no, high school word, the paper from going all the way in there. Now it doesn't matter. Once again, you're just going to try and, I think it's easier to go and take it like this and just get real slow right about there. And if you didn't cut it long enough, you could go in and I didn't cut it far enough in, I'll tell you that. You could always do it with your scissors. You know, I mean, the stamp police won't come and get you. Keep your fingers crossed that this is going to. Yeah, no, that's a little bit too small. And see, the paper was in the way. I'm not going to worry about it. This is a prototype. I've got little bits of paper down below. Okay, so see, look, I've got a little bit of bend there. Oh, boy, you know, you're going to quit speaking to me because of that, right? Oh, Okay. Now, how you do it here is up to you. You can do seal. I think I would do seal plus. And that is a half inch, so you should be able to, or else, you know, if you're not sure, this would be great, right? Because that's going to keep it. Just to, you know, that I've gone through so many of these black sheets lately. I'm going to put this down like we all should. And then just pull this across. Oh. You know, that's a little bit. I would prefer it to be closer to the edge there. Normally, it's not going to be the end of the world here. There we go. You don't want any exposed stuff. But I'm going to go and double do this, you know, make sure that's folded up real nice there. There we go. So now you're probably wondering what we're doing here. I wonder too. Now, I did this beforehand, and let's see where I put it. There it is. Here it is. What you're going to do, this is a 2 3/4 by 5 1/2 piece, right? 2 3/4 by 5 1/2. I scored a half inch from either end. You could score a little bit deeper on this end if you wanted to. It's up to you. You know, on one of the ends, it doesn't really matter. But it's important that you Hey, you know what? I'm with you, Chrissy. I am with you, Chrissy. Yes, I am. Now, okay, so because you're not going to expect this to go beyond the day, it really doesn't matter whether you attach this or not. But this, yes, it does. And this I would definitely, before I go and do anything here, I was going to put Christmas on here, but I don't think so. Because this is how it's going to be. Look at this goes in here. This goes in here like this. And only that much is going to show. So whatever you do, we'll just take this because it's here. This is from the Here's a Card set. And I'm whoa, don't do that there. And I'm just going to go, well, no. Oh, you know, that's that exact part of my personality that's going to want to, yeah, okay. Because I know it's a little bit off. And oh, yeah, baby. See, looked at, just by, what I did was I went and stamped this next to a straight line over on my grid pad. And then I put in, I saw, oh, it's a little bit high on the right-hand side. So when I put it on here, I just tilted it down a little bit on the right-hand side and boom, it came out right. Now, is that gonna happen for you every single time? Maybe not, but you can try it if you don't have a stamp positioner, right? Or like a stamparatus. By the way, was the stamparatus on the exclusion list? I don't remember seeing it. That would be a great thing to get for 10% off. Whoa. So see this part down here, if you're thinking it's going to go in and out and in and out, you could go and put a little, you know, like just a little glue dot over here. You just put a smidge, but I wouldn't do that. And, I wouldn't do that. If you are uncomfortable about that small of a pocket, and really wanted more, then you would cut this longer than 5 1/2 and then adjust it a bit. So here's what we're going to do. In fact, let's do something real quick. You You could, if you want this to be sturdier, make it out of paper, of cardstock. Which that's another thing that is. See, note to self, pay attention. All the way in, both sides. There you go. The magnets works. See? Oh, great. Okay, so you can't buy the extra magnets, but you know, come on, that's a lot cheaper. But the Stamparatus, hello, Merry Christmas. You know, hey, you know, remember, self-care. Oh, so Chrissy's doing the right thing. The first one that you make, the first one of these that you make, you know, make it out of some cardstock that you already have. You know, I mean, not cardstock, but designer series paper that you're going, oh, I do not like that piece. I'm going to use that, you know. Well, this just happened to be, there was a half sheet there. So, yeah. And I can still use that. So what you do with this, make sure that this is folded up really well. I should have put thank you on it. I would definitely use something stronger only because you want it to do things for you, right? I'm going to lay it down here, right? I'm going to shut this over it. And yeah, don't do what I just did. Make sure that it's inside. There. So now what it does, yeah, that's in there. Yep. That's in there. Cause there's only so this is what it does. Pull it up. Hello there. They pull this out. It's not attached. If they put it back in, it's no big deal because it's not, it, you'll know if it doesn't catch on that hook, but that little hook that's down there, I've used that a lot of times and it, you know, where people go in, they add, you know, extra adhesive to it and things like that. And they really don't need to, because just putting that little hook makes it go up and down. Yeah. You like that? And then, I mean, you could use just, it doesn't have to be fancy. What, because what, they're going to throw it away after all. You want it to look pretty. But if you know, it's hard. It was hard today because I'm thinking, oh, normally I would show you some cute ideas for place cards, but come on, fold a piece of cardstock in half, write their name on it and put a little leaf on it. Okay, done. I told you about that now, right? But we really shouldn't be gathering in large groups right now anyway. So, hey, yeah. So what do you do? But this, you could make this, and this would be so much nicer than handing your postal worker just a card. And, you know, if you want to give them a regular card, great. But if I went and gave them this, let's see. You can slow this down. We'll see if I do this right. Because I have, you know, I'm bow challenged. But every now and then I get them right. So, you know, you roll it around there. Right? And this time I'm going to make a loop. Right? Pull that loop down. It's hard to pull the loop down when you've got it on the bolt. And then wrap it around. I'm still holding this down with my finger. Yeah, it's upside down. But you know what? I can fix that. So do it upside down. Everything's fixable. Remember, tomorrow, no matter how it goes, if you're expecting a phone call from someone and they don't call you, guess what? Pick up the phone and call them. Don't be offended. You know, we choose to become offended. There's a lot of family issues that happen on holidays and it just really kind of I shouldn't have taken that off there. It just kind of, you know, how you handle it will actually make or break it. Yes. Yeah. You could do bunny ear bows. Yeah. Pull this back. Yeah, I moved my camera back. It was in an odd spot. And you train yourself to work so far out, and then all of a sudden it was close to me, and I'm going, no. Oh, so yeah, you know, and so if you're expecting a phone call from someone and they don't call you, guess what? Pick the phone rings both ways. The phone rings both ways. And it's not because they don't want to talk to you. It's just because they got hung up in the day. And why do we wait till holidays to do that anyway? My brother always called me when I'm walking out the door to go to my friend's house, you know, because I don't have any family here. So except Cecil and the dog, you know, and that guy. Yeah. Yeah. But, you know, hey, wouldn't this be much nicer to go and hand to, you know, your UPS guy, you know, that guy that brings you your, that brings you your Stampin' Up orders, you know, that one that they extended the special just for you. Now I am going to close off that shopping code tonight at 6 o'clock. You do want to use it because, golly, I didn't put that up here, did I? Yeah, because I go and those of you, everybody who shops on our online store gets 4 bonus tutorials, and those are sneak peeks at what we are including this month. And then, and you know, you can use whatever you want, but these are showing things with some of the new items, like the bells. You might not necessarily want to get the whole bundle, but you might like those bells themselves. So, you know, yeah, take advantage of it. And then if you use the code then or spend over $150, well, guess what? We throw in a sample of some current product. And I know what it is, and it's something that you can use during December. I'll just tell you. You know what? It doesn't... We don't either. We know who the regular guy is, but... you know, like you might hold back a nicer thing for the guy who comes all the, you know, the most, or the guy, you know, oh, this is weird. So like you have one up there with a $5 gift card and you have one in there with a $20 gift card, right? And if the guy's really nice, you grab the $20 one. And if it's just a guy who's delivering the stuff, well, guess what? He got a free cup of coffee, you know? Yeah. You know, hey, just share the love. I mean, we are supposed to be thankful. We're supposed to be grateful. You know what? We are thankful. We are grateful. And if we spread that love, guess what? It's going to be good for everyone. Hey, I am so grateful that you spent some time with me because, you know, it, you know, I might not always get it right, but I do get it. But hey, hold on 1 second. I said we were going to give away a prize, and I should on Friday too. We'll be here Friday at 1 o'clock. And, I can really tell that there's a difference now that we don't send reminders out. I'm going to work on that. The thing with the reminders is they have rules that if I talk about sales that have interacted or requested the bot within 24 hours before the show. And so I'm a rule follower, you know, sorry. And I'm loyal too. Has anybody told you that? So, hey, let's go in. And I just checked this. Hold on. So now I have to count. So I'm going to put this up here just because, you know, maybe someone's here and they don't want their husband to know. What was that number? 26. Okay, that's easy. 20. I'm going to go from the front. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It is. Drum roll, please. I think she's here. Liz. So Liz, are you still here? That was the winning winning one. Yeah. But hey, Liz, send me your address. Send me your address. And if you've got a coupon that you want to use today with the special, make sure you email me so that I can take care of that for you and we can make that happen. What's at the top of my list here is Chrissy talking about the mess she was making. See, there she is right there. Ah, ha, ha, yay. That wasn't the winning post, but that's the latest one. And that was 2 minutes ago, so I know she's still here. So anyway, like I said, be grateful, be happy, be blessed. Have a great Thanksgiving, and I will see you on Friday at 1 o'clock. Pacific time. This is Ann Clemmer and Stamper from stamperdogtalk.com, where we try to put a little ink, paper, and fun
yes.
into your day.